The question is asking to draw out all constitutional isomers for C6H14, since this chemical formula fits in the general formula of CnH2n+2, well, that means C6H14 is an alkane. We're going to use a systematic way of drawing the isomers, that way we won't accidentally leave out any structures. So do make sure you stay until the end to pick up on this systematic way of drawing. Let's start by drawing a 6-carbon chain, meaning 6 carbons connected straight in a row. Now, if I were to draw 5 carbons straight in a row and connect a carbon at the end or at the front, are they isomers? Or are they the same compound? Well, let's count. Looks like we have 6 carbons straight in a row in all 3 of the structures. So that means they're all the same. So to avoid confusion, I'll just keep the structure with 6 carbons straight in a row like that. Since there's no other way to draw 6 carbons straight in a row, let's move on to a 5-carbon chain. So we draw 5 carbon straight like that, and we stick the remaining carbon on the second carbon. What if I stick the extra carbon on the second last carbon like this? Are these two the same? When we count the carbon chain for the alkane, we always start counting from the end that is closest to the substituent. Substituent is the stuff hanging. Like you see that extra carbon hanging on carbon number 2, that is substituent. So for the furthest right structure, if we were to count, we would have to count from the right hand side. So we would have a substituent on carbon number 2. Looks like these two 5-carbon chain are the same. Continuing on with the 5-carbon chain, but now we place that extra carbon in the middle. There's no other way we can place the extra carbon on a 5-carbon chain, so we have exhausted all possibilities for 5-carbon chain. So we go from 6 carbon, then we go to 5 carbon, and we try to place the substituent in different places. And then once we've exhausted that, then we move on to a 4-carbon chain. With 4 carbons straight in a row, we have 2 remaining carbons, and we place them on carbon number 2. Let's try moving one of that carbon, the substituent, to carbon number 3. That will actually give us another isomer. Look, we have on the left hand side, the 2 substituent is on carbon 2. On the right hand structure, the 2 substituent, one is on carbon 2, one is on carbon 3. So these two are actually isomers. So we'll keep them. Is there any other way we can place the 2 remaining carbon in a 4-carbon chain? Looks like no. If we stick the extra carbon at the end, it will just lengthen the chain, making it a 5-carbon chain. What if we move to 3-carbon chain? Like that. So we have 3 extra carbons, right? So we place in 2 of the carbon on carbon 2 and 1 of the carbon on carbon 3. Do you see something? If you look closely, it's actually a 4-carbon chain, and it's the same as this guy right here. So that's it. We've drawn out all possible isomers for C6H14. To complete the structures, I've added in the hydrogens. Just keep in mind that each carbon makes 4 bonds, so subtract the number of bonds it's making with neighboring carbon and fill in with the correct number of hydrogens. To recap, the systematic way that we used was we started off with 6 carbons straight in a row, so 6 carbon chain, and then that's it. There's no other way to draw other 6 carbon chains, so we move on to 5 carbon chain. So because we have 5 carbon straight in a row, we have 1 extra carbon, so we try sticking it from carbon number 2, and then we move it to carbon number 3. And then we've exhausted all possibility, then we move on to 4 carbon chain. So with 4 carbons straight in a row, you have 2 extra carbon, right? So we start by placing 2 carbons on carbon number 2, and then we move 1 of the carbon to carbon number 3. And then we tried 3 carbon chain, and it looks like it's a repeat of a 4 carbon chain. So then we know that we have exhausted all possibilities. And that's what I mean by a systematic way of drawing isomers. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.